Good morning. We are here watching and preparing for the sunrise, which will be in about 20 minutes. Welcome everyone to the live broadcast. And while we're waiting for this momentous moment, the sun will be coming up right through the archways of the stones. I'll share with you a little bit about the history of this monument. And a huge shout out and thank you to English Heritage for providing us with the live feed and a space for us to have a conversation. The layout of Stonehenge is positioned in relation to the solstices, the extreme limits of the sun's movement. This is the shortest night of the year. The word solstice is derived from Latin sol, which means sun, and sistere, to stand still. The solstice axis is marked by station stones, and they're positioned in a rectangle on the edge of the surrounding circular ditch that Stonehenge is built on. And the short sides are in the same alignment as the Sarzen stones. Many believe this is a calendar, marking the movements of the sun was clearly important to the people who built Stonehenge, and they went to enormous effort to carefully line up the monument. No one really knows what kind of ceremonies might have taken place. But we can imagine the people gathered at the monument to celebrate the midsummer and the midwinter. Here we are closer, zooming in. Normally, tens of thousands of people would be gathered. So this is the first year that the gatherings are taking place virtually. We can now start to see the sun peeking over. It's still quite dark outside, so that's why you see a lot of film grain.
It's about 8 minutes until sunrise. Let me read the question. Is the winter solstice also seen here at Stonehenge or only summer solstice? Great question. Both winter and summer solstice are seen here. Let me show you a screenshot. This is the circle. The sunrise intersects with the heel stone. You see my highlighter. This other stone, and it passes right through the archways over here. And it makes a perfect 90 degree angle between this station stone right here, and that station stone right there. The sunset, you'll be able to see it in this direction. So the sun is setting over here, whereas the sun is rising over here. And winter solstice and summer solstice both have this alignment. And crowds gather at both times. Thank you for the question. If you have any other questions, please ask them in the chat. What year do they determine the stones were placed? Good question. It depends on who you ask. The Sarsen stones, according to archaeologists, were put up in about 2500 BC. And they're aligned to line up with the movements of the sun. However, let me do some searches. I'll put this in the chat and you can go search for yourself. Yes, even after 4,500 years, the sun still aligns with the stones. It's quite remarkable. According to Britannia, Stonehenge was built in six stages between 3000 and 1520 BC. During the transition from the Neolithic period to the Bronze Age. According to the Farmer's Almanac, founded in 1792, their website says there are five ancient sites that were aligned with the solstice and the equinox. Stonehenge, Machu Picchu, Chichen Itza in Mexico, Chaco Canyon in New Mexico, and Newgrange in Ireland. I've been to all of these except Machu Picchu. They all are magnificent places. I highly recommend you visit them. I think there may be too many clouds to see the sun. We saw it a little bit of a glimmer. Let's see what happens next. So who built Stonehenge? There are hundreds of myths and legends. Some believe it was the Danes, the Romans, the Saxons, the Greeks, even Atlanteans or the Egyptians. Maybe even Merlin. One of the most popular beliefs was Stonehenge was built by the Druids, the high priests of the Celts. However, researchers have proven this age-old theory linking Stonehenge construction to the Druids impossible. Through modern radiocarbon dating techniques, scientists have discovered that its builders completed Stonehenge over 1,000 years before the Celts ever inhabited this region. So it is older than the Celts. Most scientists agree on the modern theory that three tribes built Stonehenge at three separate times, approximately 3000 BC. Do I have any more symbols to share related to the stones? Yes, I do. I will bring up SociSnap in a moment and discuss this other symbol that is in the beginning of our ancient tab and where it comes from and what its significance is. Let's just be with the monument a little bit more.